Hola, bienvenidos a Los Angeles Times en Español, Virtual Arte Festival. Este segmento es de jóvenes y películas. Hoy vamos a platicar con Daniel Edubiges Carrera. Hola, Dani, ¿cómo estás?
Muy bien, ¿sí me escuchan?
Sí, sí, claro que sí.
Perfecto.
Bueno, estamos con Daniel Edubiges Carrera, que es cineasta y tiene varios cortos que vamos a presentar hoy. La primera es My First Movie, Primera Comunión y Soledad de los Incendios, ¿verdad? Exacto. Dani, un poquito del primer corto, que es My First Movie, que lo hiciste con jóvenes. Un poquito de eso y después empezamos a verlos.
Bueno, antes que nada, muchas gracias por tenerme en tu programa hoy. Muchas felicidades a todos que están formando parte de este festival muy impresionante y muy necesario para este momento, ¿no? Very sí. Grateful to everyone for having me today. And for everyone who's tuning in and being here with us to share these films. I know we have a limited amount of time, but I just want to say thank you to everyone.
You're and welcome, also to the
festival. Y también para ti, Juanito, que siempre has sido un campeón para todas las cosas del cine.
Entonces, you're my muchísimas favorite gracias. Director, one of my favorite directors.
No, you said you're one favorite director. You
my one favorite. Since Primera Comunión, I brag about that film all the time.
Excellent. I really appreciate that. Are you there, Juanito?
Yes, I'm here. Something's okay. Going on with my phone.
Excellent. So your question was regarding my first movie, the film. So I think the theme, el tema que vamos a tratar el día de hoy es un poco acerca de los jóvenes. It's about the youth.
Exactly.
Se trata también de, o sea, mi obra, mis películas que he hecho hasta este punto han tratado mucho así como la experiencia latina, pero joven. Entonces, entre mis propios proyectos, within my own projects, which I do and which I shoot, I have been working with a lot of youth, but I've also had the opportunity to work as an educator. También he tenido la experiencia así como de maestro. Y esta es una película que filmé con mis estudiantes a través de un programa que se llama Tribeca Teaches. It was through the Tribeca Teaches program. And so not only do I have a particular interest in working with, in starring young Latinos in my films, but also being able to work with them as Latinos como actores, pero también como, como aspirantes también al cine y enseñarles cómo pues, seguir adelante.
Love that. I love that. So how did you connect with Tribeca? What happened there? ¿Qué pasó ahí con Tribeca?
I'm actually an alum of their grant programs. I received the Rockefeller Foundation, which was being the Rockefeller Media Artist Grant through the Tribeca Film Institute. So I had been in touch with the organization, and it was actually through a fellow filmmaker and a dear friend and a very great talent, Aurora Guerrero, who recommended me for the part, for the teaching position. So I had that amazing opportunity to work with these brilliant youth. And you'll see in the film, o sea, verán en la película, que, o sea, estos jóvenes, yo no fui el director de la primera película. Our first movie, My First Movie, esa fue una película dirigida, directed within the class. Among
los estudiantes,
Los estudiantes, entonces.
Sí. ¿Y en qué parte, fue en Los Ángeles, ¿verdad? ¿En qué parte de Los Ángeles fue esto? ¿Qué, dónde, cómo, en qué ciudad fue Los Ángeles? ¿O fue en Los Ángeles?
Bueno, la parte muy interesante es que fue la primera vez que el programa que está basado en Nueva York se vino a Los Ángeles y nos queríamos enfocar específicamente, we wanted to focus specifically on just communities that are more on the outskirts of the city that may not have immediate access to working in the film industry. So this was specifically Compton, Linwood, and Southgate.
Oh, wow. Okay. And how was that? How was that?
People.
Yeah.
Sorry?
How was that going into these areas? How, did they embrace you? Did they welcome you? Or were they like, who are you? What do you want?
It was an amazing experience. I think some of the students may actually be watching. Saludos, Fernando. Saludos, Joshua, Helen, Darlin, if you guys are out there.
They were it.
It was a very warm welcoming. I think there's a lot of untapped talent. Hay muchísimo talento en estos espacios que, o sea, que es ignorado. Entonces, para mí fue una experiencia muy linda. It was a very great experience to be able to go into those communities and be able to kind of collaborate with them.
Sí, es lo que me he fijado mucho, que yo también trabajo en Campton, mismo todas esas áreas, y siempre hay una energía que está lista para, ¿verdad? De puro talento, y no tienen cómo llenar ese talento. Y hablando de primera comunión, ¿cómo fue que sucedió primera comunión? ¿Por qué primera comunión? ¿Y por qué en México? ¿Y por qué 35 millimeter? Que es más difícil de manejar cuando se maneja una película. Te da risa.
Well, Primera Comunión, First Communion, it was my graduate thesis film. Fue mi película de tesis de la universidad. It was for me to graduate film school. Estaba estudiando en Nueva York. I was studying in New York, and I knew that I wanted to
Oh,
make a
sí.
film that had a really authentic Mexican quality. Quería que tuviera una calidad auténticamente mexicana. Calles empedradas, zócalos y todo ese estilo. Entonces,
Amazing.
para mí, o sea, en algún momento lo quería filmar en Tijuana. I wanted to shoot TJ. Maybe that would really approximate the look that I was going for. But it really didn't. Entonces, decidí que iba a tener que mudarme por un año a México, a la Ciudad de México. I moved to Mexico City for a year. I connected with some producers out there, the amazing Oscar Ramírez González, Arte Mecánica. Mitzi Vanessa Arreola, they together actually just made history in Mexico by winning or being nominated for 11 Arieles, which is the most Arieles that the film has ever been. So I had a
Amazing,
really
amazing.
stellar team, tenía un equipo muy excelente, y pues juntos hicimos esta película. Filmar en 35 milímetros es algo, sabía que no iba a tener, que en ese momento, at that time, 35 mm was already kind of starting to be phased out by digital en ese momento. El celuloide ya estaba pasando de moda, o ya, o sea, lo digital lo estaba reemplazando. So I jumped on the opportunity, o sea, salté para la oportunidad de poder filmar en 35 milímetros, que es una calidad más cinematográfica, con más profundidad de campo, more depth of field, just a more cinematic look.
Y el personaje principal, ¿cómo lo conseguiste saber? Se me olvida su nombre, ¿el Laurio? ¿El Laurio?
El uterio, ajá.
Sí, el
So,
uterio, ajá.
with regard to the protagonist, I was looking for. I think this is something that I will always strive to do in my films. I worked with a casting director. Trabajé con un director de casting, y durante ese proceso, el hombre, sin saber exactamente cuál era, o sea, la calidad, así como el aspecto que estaba buscando. My casting director wasn't quite certain what I was looking for in terms of appearance and stuff. So he brought me Mexico's best and brightest. O sea, me trajo todas las estrellitas de Televisa, de Telemundo, o no de Telemundo, pero de.
You're like, no.
Y me di cuenta de que, pues, que no. O sea, como en mi experiencia dando clases en cine, también en my teaching experience, as in my casting, I believe there's a lot of untapped talent. Hay mucho talento que muchas veces por no tener, o sea, acceso, recursos, for, being kind of not really having the resources or just access, there's a lot of young people who would love to act, who would love to participate in the creative process.
And natural
Entonces,
talent too.
and for me, I think it's also, just the way that the locations really needed to be authentic, the actors also needed to be authentic. Entonces, de la misma forma que las locaciones necesitaban ser auténticas, pues también los actores. Y todos ya conocemos, o sea, lo que sucede muchas veces en las telenovelas, que tenemos un chamaquito güerito de ojos azules haciendo el papel del chavito de la calle. O sea, we have these little blue-eyed, blonde-haired children portraying these down-and-out characters, which really isn't, it just doesn't reflect reality. And I think audiences are smarter than that. Creo que las audiencias, nosotros sabemos mejor, o sea, entendemos mejor que eso no refleja la realidad. Entonces, so I found my locations first, encontré mis locaciones, and then I decided to cast within that same town. Entonces, después de encontrar la locación, hice todo el casting dentro de ese mismo pueblo. Atlatlaucan, Morelos, muchísimas gracias por aceptarnos y por ser parte de la producción. because Atlatlaucan Morelos really did become a part of the production. It wasn't just the actors, it was the people of the town itself. They embraced us, became a grassroots production. And I think it's really reflected in the film that this is not, these weren't isolated characters that came out of nowhere. Todos o sea, formaban parte de una familia. Y creo que se refleja también en la calidad y en así como en,
sí.
en la vibra de la obra. I think the vibe really does carry through in the textures and in the quality of the performance.
Sí, y lo que pasa muchas veces, bueno, a mí me gusta, yo trabajo mucho en el este de Los Ángeles, y me gusta que la comunidad del este de Los Ángeles se involucre en los proyectos, porque así ellos tienen también dueño de ese, ya sea cine, sea evento, lo que sea, también son dueños de esa cosa que estamos creando. Y parece que tú hiciste lo mismo, invitaste a la comunidad de ese pueblito para que ellos también tuvieran dueño de esta primera comunión. Yo lo que me gusta de ti, que tú siempre estás conectando, siempre te portas bien con todos, muy amable, always super nice. And every time I call you, I text you, I need something, right away you respond, and I love that about you. So I'm sure that the little pueblito just adores you. And what about the twins? You have two twins. Well, should we talk about the twins, or should we wait afterwards? Paolo, can we run the films now? Let's run the films now, and then we'll talk more about the films. Is that okay?
Whatever works.
All right. So let's run the films, and let me see here. And then we'll come back with more questions, and hopefully we'll have an audience watching, which I'm sure we will. And we'll take some of the questions from Facebook as well. And any comments that the people that you work with, if they log on to Facebook and make comments, we'll repeat those online as well and try to answer questions.
Great.
Okay? So let's run the films.
All right, can I get you two by the gate? Yeah, like that, but Angel, switch with Adriana. All right, now, Adriana, I don't want you looking at him, so face to the left. All right, now, back up a little bit, Angel. Okay, that looks good. You know what, can I get you two a little closer? Yeah, just a little bit. Okay, and action.
You're my love, my life, my everything.
Hey, come on. We're kind of in the middle of something.
Whatever.
Okay, let's try that again, but Angel, remember, she's everything to you. And action. Forget about everything else. We've almost got it. I want to see fire in your eyes. That's a wrap, guys.
Not desperate enough. Try sounding like you're angry. Come on, you know this. Almost. Come on, man. Whatever. Do you want me to find someone else to do this?
Yes.
Why didn't you just ask to borrow my camera?
Why would I ask you?
Well, better than trying to ruin my film.
You're ruining it all by yourself.
You're one to talk, zombie girl. My film was poetry.
You don't know anything about poetry.
In my film, the Aztec dancers at Plaza are the real poetry. They keep our culture alive. They remind us of where we come from.
Whatever. All of that is in the past. What matters is now, and how it feels like we're all swimming in one big sewer. And what about all the fighting everywhere? The crews and stuff. It's the hidden reality. Nobody ever even talks about it. Most of the time, it's meaningless. Anarchy.
But we're more than the violence. We survive it. We come from hardworking people.
Are you, like, trying to tell me that you're the only person that doesn't feel trapped here?
Sure. Sometimes I do. But I try not to think about that. This is home. It's beautiful. Even if it isn't the perfect neighborhood you see in movies.
Broke your camera.
Tell it to my pops. These things ain't cheap.
Whatever, your camera's old anyway. But I can probably pitch in for a new one.
Yeah, but then you'll own it too.
So?
You're annoying.
I'm not annoying. Plus, it won't be the same if we're working together. You and me as a team. It's so unexpected, it goes against the system.
Right.
It does.
So, what kind of movie would we make?
Just forget about it.
No, really.
About what we were talking about?
About living here?
Yeah.
What would we call it?
Hey, Marla! This isn't funny! Marla! Marla!
Shh. Lo que se le ofrezca, señora.
Chicles, ayúdenme con un chicle, por favor. Cómpreme un chicle, ayúdenme, tengo mucha hambre. ¿Me compro un chicle? ¿Me compro un chicle? Cómpreme un chicle, doña, por favor.
Dios, hijo mío.
¿Qué haces en nuestro barrio, mugroso? ¿Te crees uno de nosotros? Pues en esta banda no hay chivas. Ten. te hagas hombre.
Oh, ¡ay, hijo de tu pinche madre!
Sangre y el cuerpo de Cristo. La sangre y el cuerpo de Cristo. Por primera vez, Lupita y Rosita se han unido al Espíritu de Dios. En esta primera comunión, debemos reflexionar sobre la bondad de Dios y de nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Debemos conmemorar el gran sacrificio que nos permitirá un lugar en su glorioso reino. Hijos míos, esta misa ha terminado. Antes de irnos, démonos fraternalmente la paz del Señor.
Poderoso es nuestro Dios. ¡Juanito! ¡Juanito!
¡Juanito! ¡Juanito!
¡Juanito!
¡Juanito!
Para Magdalena, nos van a escuchar.
No me importa. Quiero que me escuchen. Quiero que vengan, que nos ayuden.
La migra no nos va a ayudar. ¿Me entiendes? Soledad. Vamos a encontrar a mi hija. Solé, ¿estás bien?
Lo encontré. Juanito tiene frío. Mamá. Juanito tiene frío. Está temblando, está mojado y tiene frío.
¡Soledad!
Sí, tiene frío. ¡Tiene frío! ¡Frío, frío, frío!
¡Basta, Soledad!
Casa Soledad. No, del río no.
No me voy sin él.
Tenemos que seguir. Se va a poner frío. Llegando a otro lado, pedimos ayuda.
¿Te atrevas a dejarnos?
¡Dije vamos! Sole, agarra tus cosas. ¡Se fue! ¿Qué están haciendo? ¡Se fue! ¡Qué nada!
Sergeant Sean Amigos! Let's go!
Get the hell up!
Go!
Señor, por favor, mi hijo, lo tenía que encontrar, por favor. Se lo suplico. Señor,
por favor.
What were they going on about?
Something about their son.
Did you see anyone else?
I checked. Not a soul for miles.
Bueno, pues antes que nada me gustaría saludar a mi familia, a mis hermanas, Rocío, Blanca, Mariana, mi sobrina, Brianna, Elena, my whole family. I think this last piece really it touches. Es una obra que hice, así que es muy personal. Trata sobre nuestra experiencia cruzando la frontera y siendo inmigrantes, ¿no? Entonces, para mí, you know, this is a film that really touches upon personal issues. As a first-generation immigrant, coming from an immigrant family, and kind of some of the struggles that we faced. Mi familia ha sido muy, muy, o sea, muy buena conmigo. Entienden que es un poco raro que me dedique al cine o al arte, pero okay. Me apoyan bastante. My family's been very supportive, so I feel really, really grateful for
qué
that.
Bien, qué bien. ¿Cómo se llama tu mamá, si se puede decir?
Ernestina Carrera.
Ok, saludos, señora. Saludos y felicidades con un hijo tan talentoso.
Y a mis hermanas también, que creo que están sintonizadas ahorita mismo.
Bueno, saludos a las hermanas. Entonces, hablando de Soledad, ¿cómo empezaste a crear a Soledad de los Incendios? Porque yo había escuchado, me la habías comentado hace como 10 años, me parece, cuando estuvimos en el Festival de Cine, te pregunté cuál es tu próximo proyecto y me dijiste Soledad de los Incendios, y el título me agarró. Dije, wow, that's a good title. ¿Cuál fue ese proceso del guión, de la idea, el guión y luego la producción?
Bueno, ahorita Soledad de los Incendios es un corto que hicimos con la idea también de desarrollar un largometraje. It's an idea, it's a proof of concept short for a longer feature project. No son iguales, they're not the exact same films, pero después de Primera Comunión, after First Communion, for me it's been about trying to go a little more in a direction of maybe slight ghost story, horror, o sea, entrar un poquito más en el género sobrenatural, historias de fantasmas, pero arraigado, o sea, con la raíz, así como todavía muy personal, muy conectada con cuestiones sociales y de nuestras experiencias como una comunidad latina y de lo que se trata ser inmigrante. So they're not just stories that I think I want to go into more of a horror style, but also still rooted in the experience of the immigrant,
and our process. Issues, a lot of the issues that we are affected by. In Primera Comunión, you tackle the issue, well, you present the issue of an absent father, alcoholic father, gang violence among youth, and the cycle of gang violence. So all those topics are there, and I love it. So before we go off, I think we have like 2 minutes. What is your next project? What are you working on right now?
Well, I have two projects, and they're both a combination of Soledad de los Incendios and Primera Comunión. One is based in rural Mexico. I would love to return to Mexico. Me encantaría poder volver a México y filmar así como entre esas texturas mexicanas. Yeah. Es una historia acerca de los exorcismos en pueblos pequeños. It's a story about exorcism in small towns and the way that affects particularly queer people, o sea, en particular la gente que es gay y en espacios pequeños, rurales, en provincia y lo que significa eso. And then also a feature project, también un largometraje que trata la historia de una mamá inmigrante aquí en Estados Unidos y el espíritu de un hijo perdido.
Oh, wow, heavy, heavy, heavy. You tend to do that with your films. So I wanna. We have 1 minute left, real quick. Why film? What possessed you to go into film?
I think for me, film is the ultimate art, and film is the ultimate kind of visual language. It incorporates music, it incorporates performance, it incorporates visuals as much as kind of like production design and every one of those elements. El cine es como poder prestar un sueño, ¿no? It's being able to relate a certain level of a dream. For me, it's just so incredibly powerful. Y desde niño he tenido así como el impulso de relatar historias de esa forma. And since a young child, I've always been drawn to being able to relate stories at that level.
You're an amazing storyteller. Going back here to some of my questions, did you have access to filmmaking when you were a child? Did you have any access to tools? When did you first have access to those tools?
Well, I keep making shout outs to my sisters because I think ultimately it was always during Thanksgiving that we would get together and I would use all of my siblings, all of my nieces, my nephews, and I would steal my sister's cameras because, you know, that was back in the day of the big heavy VHS camera.
Yeah.
I would steal it for like 3 hours, run off into the backyard or into like other rooms. And then at the end of Thanksgiving, we would have a little bit of a film festival for my family.
That's just great.
Little kind of knockoff, you know, just we would. They were satires about the family. And we would just, like, when my sister Rosie was pregnant, my niece and I made a little film about, you know, what it must be like for her to be pregnant. But these are things that we would shoot in a matter of, like, you know, 30 minutes to an hour and then present it at the end of the day. So it's always been family-oriented for me to a certain extent. Yeah. And it's always been rooted in kind of, like, getting us together and telling stories that feel really immediate.
Yeah, no, that's amazing. So we have to close it off here, Danny, and I want to thank you for bringing all these messages to through your films. It means a lot to me. The films that you allow me to present to our youth, which has been Primera Comunión in my first movie, the kids always have tons of questions. And Primera Comunión, they always relate to it because even though this movie is in Mexico, they relate to the violence that they're going through here in East LA. So I thank you so much for allowing us to screen that film and for allowing that film, Primera Comunión, to have an open dialogue with our kids. And you and I have become officially or unofficially ambassadors of the East LA Women's Center because our films deal with topics relating to women. And este segmento es dedicado para ellos, para East LA Women's Center, que ayudan a mujeres que son víctimas de violencia doméstica. Y si pueden donar algo, un dólar o dólares, por favor, métanse a su website de ellas. Es ELA, East LA Women's Center, ELAWC.org. Y si tienen preguntas, nomás hagan Google East LA Women's Center. Y
I would also like to make a quick shout out. Thank you to Barbara Capos, to Heidi, to all of the amazing women who on the, you know, on the east side of LA are really kind of making important, they're making important moves to make sure that our Latina sisters, our mothers, our nieces, our daughters are being taken care of, our transgender sisters, that all of us are really being taken care of. And I'd like to give a shout out to my forevers, Luis, Miguelito, Visper, David Rodriguez, David Leonardo. All of you people have kept my filmmaking alive and I couldn't be more grateful. And of course,
amazing. Danny, te quiero mucho.
And you, Juanito.
Sí, no, gracias a ti también por todo. Te quiero mucho, ya sabes, y cualquier cosa, ya sabes. Un texto y ahí estamos. Bueno, Danny, gracias y hasta pronto.
Muchas gracias a todos por sintonizar. Les agradezco.
Vale, pues. Continuamos con el Festival Virtual Arte 2020. Y el próximo segmento va a empezar ahorita en un segundito. Gracias.